We will see addition of two-dimensional arrays. Before this, we have seen how to declare and initialize the variables in two-dimensional array. In this lecture, we will see addition of two-dimensional array. So first array, suppose integer a of 2, 2. So this is my first array named a. Second two-dimensional array, and third I have to take, as I am going to add two arrays, so whatever the answer is there, we have to store it into third array. Again, I have to take two variables of type integer to retrieve the for loops. So for I is equal to 0, I less than 2, I plus plus. So this for loop I have written for rows, and j is the for loop I am writing for columns. I'm inserting the elements for first array, %d, comma address of a of I, comma j. So these statements I have written to take input for the elements of array A. So total array A consists of 4 elements, array B consists of 4 elements. As both arrays contains 4 elements, the addition will contain, or addition will generate obviously 4 elements. For that also I am taking 2-dimensional array named C, where I can store the addition of it. So I am copying these things as I have to take input for the array B also. So here only I have to make a little change, that instead of pushing the values into the A, I am pushing the values inside the array B here. Okay, so what I have to do is, again I have to use two for loops to retrieve, and instead of writing scanf statement, what I have to write here is C of I j is equal to A of I j plus B of I j. So what will happen here? So initially the value of I is 0, j is 0. So the C of 0, 0th position, what value we will get is addition of A of 0, 0 plus B of 0, 0. So first element of both the arrays will get added, and the whatever answer will generate, that will be stored onto C of 0, 0th position. For the same, it will happen for 4 times. As the I is less than 2 and j is less than 2 will be there, it will happen for 4 times, and 4 different types of values will get generated by adding the values, and the array C will get formed. What we have to do next is, we have to print the elements from the array C. Again, we have to use two for loops because C is also two-dimensional array, and instead of scanf, we have to write printf statement, as we are going to print the elements, and it is generated inside the C array. So C array I have to print. So this is the program. I will run the program. Okay. So for array A, I have to include the values. Suppose my first element is 1, second is 2, third is 3, next is 4. Now I have to insert the element for array B. Again, I am inserting same values, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now see, 1 plus 1, we will be getting the value 2 here. Next is 2 plus 2, 4, 3 plus 3, 6, and 4 plus 4, 8. As I have not written slash n here in printf, all the values are printed in one line only. If I am writing slash n here, what it means, all the values will print on next line every time. You can check here. Run. So first, suppose I'm entering different values here. So first element will be 12, second will be 11, third will be 22, and fourth will be 33. Next, for B array, first element will be again 12. Next is suppose 23. Next is 34. Next is 45. So these are the elements. So if I'm adding the elements, means I will get the answer like this. So this is the array C. First element of array C is 24. Next is 34. Next is 56. And next is 78. So by using this logic, you can write a program to add two-dimensional arrays. For this, we are totally using three 2-dimensional arrays. First one is A, second one is B, and third one is C. Whatever the number of dimensions of arrays are there, that much number of for loops you have to write into your program. So this is the simple program to add two 2-dimensional arrays. Thank you.